Well, farmers and ranchers, all of us really have needed some support in the form of rain, and several counties around here received that benefit today.
Music to our ears. Mm-hmm. And as you well know, it's been a remarkably dry few months. KTAP's Noah McKinney tells us how the lack of rain is affecting those farmers and their bottom line.
2021 started off pretty dry, and then the strangest thing happened.
February, if you remember, we had the snow apocalypse, which would be Winter Storm Uri.
Taylor County Extension agent Steve Estes says what came after the snow was good for area farmers.
From there till about mid-June, quite a bit of rain, and it fell pretty frequently around Abilene in the big country.
Area farmer Tim Shields says he's not complaining. Well, not much.
We were one rain away from just having a home run with cotton, and it's not going to be bad, but it's not going to be as good as it looked like it could be.
Tim farms cotton and wheat. Much of his crop was being planted around March. He says a September rain would have done well for his yield.
Quit raining in July, it's like the good Lord just shut it off. And we haven't had any measurable rain here since July.
And while cotton is doing just fine, it's the cattle that may suffer.
If we don't get a good wheat crop up for cattle grazing, then that will that would affect local farmers and ranchers.
Ranchers that grow fields of wheat for their cattle, but if that wheat doesn't grow, the cattle can't graze.
So that would affect their bottom line as far as any profits.
Shield says the wheat he did plant didn't do well, forcing him to get creative.
We planted the wheat acres that we plowed up to milo, and the milo did really, really well.
Milo being a wheat-like crop that's used as animal feed.
Doesn't take as much rain to finish milo as it does cotton.
While there is some rain in the forecast, Tim will be the first to tell you that it doesn't always fall where you want it.
North of Anson, they had some rain that we didn't get, and south of Abilene had some rain we didn't get.
For BigCountryHomepage.com, I'm Noah McKinney.
Thank you, Noah. The Shield says that he will likely harvest his cotton in October, which may see a good return this year. Cotton right now selling for more than usual at almost a dollar a pound.